There can be a fair amount of rail activity in north-central Illinois if one knows where to look. In this video, I'll capture movement among Rockford, Rochelle, and Davis Junction. And we start with the Grand Trunk Western Heritage Motor, Canadian National SD70M-2 8952, leading M337 on the main at Colvin Park. I wanted a good side shot of this motor, so I went to the Rock River, where several rail fans had gathered to capture the event. The Lane Street boat ramp makes an excellent spot for evening catches with sun. I then moved to the top of the grade away from the Rock River Valley at Allworth. The signal illuminates as 337 moves into the block and climbs toward Allworth Road. Thank you. On Wednesday, I heard that Norfolk Southern AC44C6M 4004 was leading Manifest 338 out of Waterloo. As I went to the Seminary Street Bridge, I thought this was what I was going to catch. However, it was a grainer led by a UP motor. I was unable to stay out any longer, so I concluded my railfanning for the night. The following day, I went to Cherry Valley and Perryville Road, where I caught 337, with two SD70M-2s sandwiching an SD75I. In my haste, I forgot that the late afternoon sun was now on the north side of the tracks at Allworth, thanks to daylight saving time and spring. So this capture is on the shadowed side at the Allworth turnout. When I woke Friday morning, I saw that an eastbound had been lined at West Junction in Freeport. A quick listen to the Broadcastify archives for the Dubuque area revealed that this was U714. I moved to the Morgan Street Bridge for a shot that I had wanted for some time. Canadian Pacific K66 was then lined onto the Illinois Railway after U714 passed. The sun was nearly perfect for a few 100-meter shots at Baxter and Blackhawk Roads. I've previously mentioned that it's easy to chase K66 as they only move about 10 miles per hour on Illinois Railway trackage. Here, they move through the fields between Baxter Road and Ensign Road. I originally planned to follow K-66 on its return trip north. However, on a whim, I went to Rochelle after realizing it had been some time since I had been to the Diamond. As I arrived at the Rochelle Rail Park, the Rochelle switcher was shoving toward Del Monte Foods. They take their turnout east of the Diamond, then shove around toward the southwest side, adjacent to Union Pacific trackage. We'll see them two other times in this video as well, when they return east and on their trip west toward Oregon. If I read correctly, the local is symboled LCHI-108. Fifteen minutes after they were out of sight, a Union Pacific westbound manifest arrived. Thank you. The Rochelle switcher would return east a quarter hour after this manifest passed. Once the gates had risen, I made it about halfway across the mains before an eastbound BNSF intermodal arrived. Once they were off the diamond, a clear aspect appeared on the westbound UP cantilever. I had started my vehicle to leave the park when I heard a faint rumbling behind me, which was an eastbound UP intermodal. Another hurdle presented itself as I attempted to leave town at North Main Street. The Rochelle switcher was going west with a full consist toward the Diamond. After a brief nap, I concluded the day in downtown Rockford, on the CN Freeport sub. M337 was approaching Morgan Street with a trio of SD70M-2s.